Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to simulate a business conversation in PowerPoint. Actually, thanks to the new content library, you can get started right away by just adding a template. Down here at the bottom, we've got a few simulation templates to choose from. This conference room scenario has a nice business feel, so you can mix and match any of these to get started. Don't forget to put your own text here, or just get rid of the text box if you don't need it. Plus, you can swap out backgrounds and characters if you like. Before I show you how to swap out this character, I want to give you a couple of tips on creating realistic conversations. Thanks to the many poses and angles, you can make sure your characters are always facing each other to maintain eye contact. You should also make full use of all the poses and emotions to keep your learners engaged in the topic. For example, if a character is confused, pick a pose like this, which illustrates that. This last slide here may look a little awkward since the guy is looking off to the side, but you can also use subtle effects like this to show that he's looking at someone else approaching. Another thing to watch out for is perspective. Since he's a little further back, you'll want to make him a little smaller than the lady in the foreground. But whatever you do, just make sure it looks natural. Okay, now I'll show you how easy it is to find the right stuff in the character library. Over here on the left, I'm going to show you how to find the right character by narrowing down the criteria. So, we want a male, businessman, 25 to 40, ethnicity doesn't matter, but we definitely want him standing, and we also want a diagonal front view. Don't worry, we can always mirror this later so he's facing the lady. And here we've got a whole range of emotions to choose from. Don't forget to use the full palette to maximize your creativity. I'm gonna pick bored. Oh man, this one with the coffee is hilarious. Alright, now all I need to do is use the standard PowerPoint editing functions to get him squared away. First, I'll crop off his legs, and then I'll swing over here to the picture tools and select flip horizontal. Now all I gotta do is delete his buddy and then resize him to fit. Okay, now the final thing I'm gonna show you is the background library. It's pretty straightforward. It works the same way as replacing a character. And again, here in the background library, you can narrow down what you're looking for here on the left. And as you can see, there's a bunch of different office backgrounds to choose from. Once the new background is inserted, just send it to the back, and then click here and delete the previous background. And that's it! Thanks for watching! Do you use conversation simulations as part of your training? Tell us about it in the comments below.
Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.